Thank you, dear ministers, advisors, ladies and gentlemen. If you still have enough energy left in you after the interesting presentations of this morning, I will now attempt to explain the technical viewpoints of this project, focusing on four key elements, the context, the project concept, the outcomes, and the implementation. Several studies have demonstrated the need for a strengthening of the logistics in the Mediterranean partner countries. These studies have allowed us to identify, through in-depth analysis, the issues and weaknesses of this sector. We will concentrate on these primary factors. The current economic framework causes delays in integration at the regional level and allow logistics sector involvement, cooperation, and modernization. Moving on to the public and private sector, we can identify asymmetries among priority across governmental departments, an insufficient number of national and international operators to give visibility to the sector, and finally a lack of organization of logistics sector companies into a professional association. If we look at the training and information flows, we can find a gap in expertise and best practices knowledge in logistics, a lack of training in this gap, and a gap of updated information to support the investment actions and decisions and the public plans. In this context, the adoption of separate strategies by each country hinders overcoming the current difficulties and obstructs the realization of an effective system of trade at the regional level. Considering all these aspects, we can identify a need to determine a concrete common action plan, create a logistic training that encompasses the whole Mediterranean region, and establish common training quality labels. As you well know, LogisMed TA is training activities, is a part of the broader initiative, so-called LogisMed, by the European Investment Bank, which aims to implement a new Euro-Mediterranean network of logistics platforms. In this regard, a specific study titled "A Euro-Mediterranean Network of Logistics Platform" was published by the EIB in 2009. The logistic platform, the new logistic platform, will be based on international standards for both the infrastructure and the services, and a framework conducive to development of a private enterprise will be created, allocating the role of coordination and the support to the public sector. Finally, the LogisMed EIB initiative is included as an concrete action, the Action 17, in the Regional Transport Action Plan 2007-2013 of the Euromed transport. And now, the concept of the project. What is it? The creation of a network of a logistic platform is a physical instrument to promote integration, but cannot be separated by the strengthening of the culture and the dissemination of logistic expertise in the region. In this regard, LogisMed TA aims to increase the supply and the level of skills and the qualification of the personnel who will work in the network of logistic platform once they become operational. Training in transport and logistics is an absolute priority in the partner countries as a whole, and provides an opportunity for a common program which will lead to more in-depth knowledge of the region and an alignment of viewpoints between the two shores of the Mediterranean. Vocational training will be offered to the private sector and at the same time to the government departments. It will include management as well as technical knowledge, technical factors, and be essentially practical, not only academic. It will be based on examples directly related to the level of countries. LogisMed training activities requires two additional actions that will complement the LogisMeta project, namely the coordination between platforms and the regional observatory, the creation of a regional observatory. The coordination will allow to orient training action in relation to the progressive activation of the network of the logistics platforms. With the regional observatory, we will have the possibility to update data through a next post evaluation mechanism in order to have a follow-up on policies and to incorporate a timely modification of the strategy. The evaluation of effects of the training action plus guidance on the learning process towards geographical areas and sectors will provide ongoing and updated training to the market needs. There is a very close connection between the construction, the physical realization of the platform and LogisMeta. In fact, through the actions of training, we will be able to have the personnel for the platforms ready to operate in the platforms before the platform will be activated. For this reason, EIB, there is at the same time promoter of the broader initiatives and of the initiatives we today are launching, LogisMeta, already funded four feasibility studies of platforms in Egypt, Jordan, Morocco, and Tunisia to analyze all the technical, environmental, financial, institutional, and market elements related to the infrastructure. The first of these studies was launched in May 2012 and concerns the construction of a platform in Tunisia, Jebel Oust. The other studies on the logistics platform of 6th of October in Egypt, Casablanca in Morocco, and the logistics hub in the region of Amman in Jordan are being launched. And now let me look at the outcomes, the expected results in the Mediterranean. The concrete effect of the training will have an impact at country level and at platform level, because the actions of action plan are addressed both to the all Mediterranean partner countries for what concerns the spread of knowledge, and specifically to the first three platforms of the network. At country level, we expect a clear improvement of training offer and demand, a support from national administrations in each country, and a creation of a pool of logistics specialists at various levels. For what concerns the action at platform level, we will have the availability, as I told before, of trained personnel once the platform are activated, and common criteria to logistics companies which will operate in the platforms of the network. A general contribution of this project is expected for the regional integration of the area, of the Mediterranean area, reducing logistics cost, creating a free trade area, and fostering cooperation between the transport or state transport operators and the private operators. As the ambassador told before, a very concrete result on the job creation and to the improvement of social condition in the region as a whole. Specifically, we expect a direct training impact for what concerns the certification of European Logistic Association that will benefit 300 professionals throughout the region, a specific program for trainers that will benefit 15 trainers per platform, an establishment of a first group of white collars, the management that will manage the platforms, that will benefit from 100 to 200 managers per platform, depending on the dimension of the platform. And finally, the establishment, it is a very, very original thing for this project, of a permanent training unit for each platform that will benefit from 200 to 400 workers per platform. And now the implementation, the methodology of implementation. Several non-profit organization will handle actions in the field and pursue the objective of Logismeta in collaboration with the most important national and regional institution in the Mediterranean. SETMO, the Union for Union of Mediterranean Universities, the International Road Transport Union, and the Arab Academy are the most important organization in this field. And at the same time, there is also a steering committee that will be responsible for supervising and verifying compliance with the overall objective of Logismeta. And UFM, EIB, European Commission, World Bank, and the partner countries will take place in this governing body. The project will be delivered with a timeline of 6 years, starting from 2013 until 2018, and will be divided in two phases, of which the first phase will include the training activities at country level that will regard all the 10 Mediterranean partner countries, and a training of a first group for a first group of three platforms in Egypt, Morocco, and Tunisia. The second phase will continue the spreading of knowledge in the Mediterranean, in all the countries, will include two other platforms in the training activity dedicated especially of the, to the platforms, and finally will include the two complementary action, the platform coordination, and the creation of a regional observatory. The UFM Secretariat will play a major role in the project management. Specifically, the Transport and Urban Development Division will check, will verify the compliance with the project, of the project with the roadmap, the costs, the UFM criteria. The maintenance of a high quality of project performance in the field, and finally the coordination at the regional and extra-regional level with other projects and initiatives in close collaboration with the Euromed Forum, with the EC, EIB, World Bank, the Group of Ministers of Transport of the Western Mediterranean. Let me to conclude now. I would like to focus on the strengths of this project. The approach followed to conceive and launch this project is without doubt an innovative approach, since Logismeta was established with a strategy bottom-up at the request of the partner countries to put in place a training program at the regional level which integrates and complements the training action already in progress in the Mediterranean partner countries at national level. Moreover, Logismeta is a project that complies with ongoing projects and the most important initiatives in the field of transport. For example, the motorways of the sea that will connect the ports of the south shore of the Mediterranean to the port of the northern shore. And the project will provide training also for the platforms that are close to the ports. And the infrastructure project for the construction of a trans-Mediterranean transport network will be in close connection with this project that will provide the physical connection between the platforms. And finally, the updating of the regional transport plan in the Mediterranean and so on. Finally, LogisMeta is a project, is an effective tool to involve both the public and the private sector. In fact, the training with a win-win strategy because the training will be addressed not only to the technical staff that will manage the operation in the platforms, but also to the technical staff of national institutions, so that they will be able to enhance the ability of coordination and the strategic guidance of the logistics sector. I would like to conclude that I'm convinced that the project will contribute to the consolidation of the Mediterranean logistic network as a natural expansion of the Europe logistics market, but also as a bridge for the opening of commercial and logistic activities in the future throughout all the African continent. I thank you for your attention, for your time.